Hello children, a pleasant good morning to you all. We had ended with two units and now we are entering into a new unit, unit 3, which is life. Right? Now in that first we have to recall the concepts what we had learned in your previous classes. What are the concepts we learned in the previous classes? Under the previous unit, force and pressure. Right? We had learned surface tension, viscosity and friction. I hope you had completed your classwork and submitted your works, right? Okay. First, recall all those concepts. Along with that, we have to recall some, remember the basic concepts you would have learned in your lower classes. What is about light? What are all the properties of light? Like it will travel in straight line, it will get reflected, refracted, how we are able to see the objects, all those you have to recall. Okay. Right. Now, in this content, today's class, we are going to see the definition and introduction about light, and we are going to see about mirrors and its types, and there are some terms related with spherical mirrors and image formation in different types of mirrors. Right? Okay. First, we will move into the definition of light. Right? It is not a big complex definition. It's a very basic definition. Light is a form of energy which travels in a straight line. Simple as that. Light, of course, it light, air, light, heat, sound, like that. Light is also a form of energy. But what is the main property is it will travel always in a straight line, right? But children, when you move into your higher classes, you can know about, you can learn that light always also travels in the form of waves and packets of energy, right? But as of now in your lower classes, please keep in mind light will travel in a straight line. This straight line travel only will lead to wave form of travel and all. That and all you will learn in your higher classes. Now light travels in the straight line, right? Now usually whatever we see in this world, only when light gets incident on it we will be able to see, right? Even when we are in the dark place, right, we can see the objects which are in the light, right? But if the object is in the darkness, even if we are there in the light, we will not be able to see the objects. That means what? When we are able to see an object, light must incident on that object and get reflected towards us, then only we will be able to see it. Okay, children. Now, there are so many instruments which work on the principle of light traveling in a straight line and uses the light also. Right? In that, a very important instrument is mirror. First, the definition for mirror is, it is an optical device with a polished surface that reflects the light falling on it. I'll tell you the real-time example. You would have seen your ordinary plain mirror at home. That is your made-up mirror, right? So that mirror you will see, mirror is nothing but an ordinary glass plate. Okay, it is an ordinary glass plate. I'll show you one, right? So this is one type of mirror. I'll tell you what type is it afterwards. Now see, this is just a glass plate, okay? But it is polished at another side. Now for you differentiate it is in a color, but normal light usually at the back side it will be polished either with aluminium, mixture of aluminium or silver, right? So it will get that, what is that, mixture range ratio varies from glass to glass, okay? So what is that? Mirror is just a glass plate. A typical mirror is just a glass plate with one side polished. Polished means what? It will not do any reflection, but the other unpolished surface will reflect the light. That is what it has been written over here. It is an optical device. Of course, it is an optical device. Optical devices are nothing but any device which works with the help of light. So it is an optical device with a polished surface. See, this is your polished surface, and this light will reflect the light. Now, next we are going to see about types of mirrors. We have two main types of mirrors. One is plane mirrors and curved mirrors. Right? Plane mirrors is just a an ordinary mirror what we have at home, right? So it will be straightened surface, one side will be polished as I said either with aluminium or silver, and other side will be reflecting surface, right? Now we have another type of mirrors called as curved mirrors. In this, how they form images are, plane mirrors give a perfect image. That is, as it is, how the object is standing in front of the mirror, exactly the same image will be shown in the plane mirror, and that image we call to be virtual image. Okay, what is that virtual image? In your lower classes you have studied, I think, right? So virtual images are the images which you cannot get on a screen. I'll show you a type of screen. So this is a type of screen, right? Now I'll tell you an example, you just correlate with it, right? Now I'm the object, now a plane mirror is in front of me, right? So now I can see my image in the plane mirror, right? Now if I replace the plane mirror and keep a screen here, can you understand what I'm saying? Before, if I have a plane mirror, I can see my face inside the plane mirror, right? Now, if I replace the plane mirror by a screen, will I able to see my image on inside the screen? No. Only in the mirrors we can get. So that type of images which I cannot obtain on a screen are called as virtual images. But certain images we can get on a screen. For example, your cinema theater screen, right? Have you ever watched in your cinema theater, when you go on for any cinemas, some flash of light will be coming from a small code and it will be projected on the screen. Yes, so that is some light images only they will send through the projectors, and they are projected on the screen. So any image which can be projected on the screen are called real images. So basic question only. So this question I had added in your notes. So don't worry, right? So now these plane mirrors will form what type of images? Virtual and erect. Erect means what? Straight, not inverted and all, right? But only thing, it will give you an laterally inverted image. That means what? Left appears to be right, and right appears to be left. We ever seen that in the mirror, children? For example, this fold of sari, when you may see in the mirror, it look like this type of fold comes this side, right? Even when you raise your right hand, it appears to be, it is at left side. So that inversion is called as lateral inversion. But upside down is real inversion, okay? Laterally, sideways inverted. Which image formed by a plane mirror. So image formed by a plane mirror is virtual, erect, and laterally inverted. Note it down. Okay. Right. Now next one, what are the types of mirrors? Curved mirrors. Curved mirrors will give you in size, either it will not give the exact size of the image, either it will give diminished image or enlarged image. Diminished means smaller in size, enlarged means bigger in size. How much it will be diminished, how much it will be enlarged, we will see. We are going to see now. So what are the two types of mirrors? Plane mirrors and curved mirrors. Now that is what I had written here. Mirrors are classified into plane mirrors and curved mirrors. Curved mirrors are again divided into four types. Number one, spherical mirrors, cylindrical mirrors, parabolic mirrors and ellipsoid mirrors. Say the words once again along with me. Spherical mirrors, cylindrical mirrors, parabolic mirrors and ellipsoid mirrors. Ellipsoid. In that, we are going to learn about spherical mirrors in detail and parabolic mirrors a little information. The other two types you will learn in your other classes, right? Now, the spherical mirrors, we have two types. They are concave mirrors and convex mirrors, right? Why the word spherical mirrors? First, you have to learn that. The spherical mirrors, it looks like it forms a part of a sphere. Right? So like a ball shape, you can think like that, right? From a ball, if you cut a piece, so one small piece you will get, no. So these mirrors look like a part of spherical shape, a spherical shape to an object, a glass object, right? So that's why it looks, they are named as spherical mirrors. So there are two types, I said, concave mirrors and convex mirrors. So usually when we represent a mirror on the board, especially this concave and convex, we represent like this, this alone, right? So here, this part I had marked like this, more like a stray marks here, right? That would have been shaded in your book, right? For you to differentiate, I had marked like this. For you in your book, it will be shaded. So this is that part is this polished surface. Now I will show you a concave mirror and convex mirror. See here, children. So these are, I can touch and see. You can get interested, get involved in the class and see the touch, right? So one mirror is this and another mirror is this. One is concave mirror and another is convex mirror, right? Concave mirror will be thinner at the center, right? Thicker at the edges. Convex mirror will be thicker at the center and thinner at the edges. So as you come to your classes, real-time classes, you can touch this mirror and feel, right? Even in your houses, you will have rear view mirrors. In your vehicle, side mirrors are there, no? They are called convex mirrors. You can touch and feel, right? Now you see here. So concave mirrors, this is how we represent it, right? So one side is polished. So this side, so to show the polished surface, so I had drawn like this, but usually in your book, it will be what is that, shaded. So every time we cannot waste our time in shading. So that's why easily I used to do it, right? So now inside part, this part. So this is your reflective part. Okay. So now this part on this looks like it is a part of a sphere. So a round sphere. So that's why these mirrors are called what type of mirrors? Spherical mirrors. Now here, R and P I have noted. R means reflecting surface, P means polished surface. Polished surface, no reflection happens. Right? What is that? Reflecting surface only will reflect like this surface. Right? Now you see here, this is concave. How we can see here, this is convex. So the inside portion is shaded. So the outer portion is reflecting and inside portion is polished. Okay, you can ask me now a question. Ma'am, little confusing. How we can identify these type of mirrors in drawing, right? So real time we can touch and feel. In drawing, how we can identify? I tell you a shortcut, right? So if the reflecting surface, okay, what surface? Reflecting surface is towards the center of the sphere. So if the reflecting surface is just facing the center of the sphere, then it is concave mirror. If the polished surface, otherwise, if the reflecting surface is away from the center, then it is convex mirror. Is it clear, children? Right? In your book, the definition has been given like this. Reflection happens at the concave surface. Concave surface means a deeper part, curved part. So, okay, always think like this. If the mirror is like this, right? So, if this curved part is concave part, the bulged part is called as convex part, right? If the reflection happens in the concave part, so like this, then it is what type of mirror? Concave mirror, right? If that side, the bulged part, so this side, like this, right? Then that type of mirror is called as convex mirror. Can you understand these two, children? Now here some properties I have to explain you. Concave mirrors will always magnify the images. Magnify means what? It will enlarge the image. And that is why it is used in makeup mirrors, not the makeup mirror what we use in our houses, right? In your saloons, beauty parlors, and in shading, you know, even the light tracks, they can the mirror will show, give you an enlarged image, right? Even in your dentist will use this type of mirrors. So they cannot see the deeper part, no. So they use these mirrors. So they will give magnify and show you, right? Now and then one, the next one is convex mirror. It will show you a diminished image, smaller image. So it is mainly used in rear view mirrors, what we use in our vehicle, side mirrors, right? So even a bigger vehicle or bigger bus, bigger trucks, it will be shown like a smaller one, right? Have you ever seen, children, inside it, it would have been written, objects in the mirror are closer than they appear. Have you seen these words on your rear view mirrors? Why it is written like that? Because the image shown in the mirror is smaller. Suppose it is smaller as it is convex mirror, and convex mirror always gives you diminished image. But inside the mirror, the image formed will appear like it is so closer, right? But the real time object, if the car is coming, for us the car will be appearing as the distant way. But really the car will be little closer to us, because it is the nature of the image formed by the convex mirror to show the image in a distant way. But we should not understand, we should not, what is that, interpret that at the same distance only the vehicle is coming at the back. We should just always interpret that image, that vehicle is still more closer. Then only we can ride appropriately. Okay. So these are very important points, children. Concave mirrors will magnify the images, and it is used as makeup mirrors. Convex mirrors always show you a diminished image, and it is used in rear view mirrors. And if the reflection happens in the concave part, or if the reflecting surface is facing the center of the sphere, then it is concave mirror. If the polished surface is towards the center of surface, and if the reflection happens at the convex part, then it is convex mirror. Okay. Now we are moving to the next type, which are called the parabolic mirrors this time. Right. The parabolic mirrors, why it is having this name? It looks in the shape of a parabola. Parabola is just in this wave form, right? Like one hour, what is it? A string, like U-shaped string. So this is the shape of a parabola. One simple example, the spread out umbrella, we can see. Right, so that is the shape of a parabola, hence the name parabolic mirrors. Now it will always have concave reflecting surface. That means what? In this shape, which is a concave part, the curved part only is called as, what is that, concave part. So the inside part only will always reflect in the parabolic mirrors, and it will focus entire beam of light at focus or diverge parallel to the principal axis. So this point is little complex, I'll explain. Right, one simple example I tell you, children. Have you ever seen these dish antennas at your top of your houses, like DTH antennas you are seeing nowadays, right? So it is in the shape of a parabola. What is that shape? It is not a mirror. Just for your understanding of the examples I'm telling you, right? But this parabolic shape will always have an advantage of receiving all the waves or rays reaching it, right? That is the work of the antenna too. It will converge all the rays at one particular point, right? And also from that focus point, it will diverge, it will reflect all the waves in the other, all directions also. So these parabolic mirrors will have the property of converging all the light rays at one point and diverging all the light rays at different directions. So that's why when we need any light rays to travel in a wrong direction, instead of using these type of mirrors, spherical mirrors, they will go for parabolic mirrors, because to get a more amount of light in a different direction, what they will do? They will focus the light on the parabolic mirror and they will diverge it in all directions. Okay. Now here, that is why they are called as parabolic reflectors. They are called as parabolic. This I'll tell you an example, children. In auditoriums, when you play, when you see the cricket, especially the nowadays IPL crickets, when you see the stadium, when you see the balls for sixers and all, you watch them, right? So here and there they fix this parabolic reflectors only. So here in a stadium or an auditorium, we cannot demand a little amount of light. And that's also the stadiums and all, night matches will be there. So heavy light to see the movement of the balls is needed, right? For that, what they will do, they here and there they will fix this parabolic reflectors. So if reflectors is kept there, so light will be diverged in all directions. So that is what they have kept told here. They will collect or project light. Either it will collect or it will project light. Right? Not only light, children. Heat, sound, even the radio waves in your radio stations and TV stations, the antenna kept over here there are all will be in the, using the parabolic reflectors only, right? So even in your telescopes, why do we use telescope? To see distant objects, right? So like binoculars, right? A type of telescope, simple telescope, right? To view the astronomical objects, we use telescopes. So to see that the heavier image, broader image can be seen when we use this parabolic reflectors. See how, what is the modern use? Even it is this reflectors are now used in solar heaters and solar cookers. That means what? When we use the parabolic reflectors in cookers and heaters, sunlight can be converged at one point. So heavy heating can be obtained, and to the vessel it will be diverged at all the directions. So easily cooking can be done. Okay. So these are all the details about parabolic mirrors. We will continue with the other concepts. The next topic is terms related to concave spherical mirrors. Especially we are going to see with the help of with reference to concave mirrors. What are the terms we are going to see? Center of curvature, pole, radius of curvature, vertex, principal axis, focus, and focal length. Okay, so I'll say it once again: center of curvature, pole, radius of curvature, vertex, principal axis, focus, and focal length. Now I'll explain these terms one by one with the reference to concave mirror. In your book, it is given along with convex mirror also. So whatever the explanation given to this, that is fit to convex mirror also. But when you are if the specialist asks in the examination, it is enough to explain with one type of mirror, whichever is easier for you, either concave mirror or convex mirror. So now here, what type of mirror is this? Polished at the outer side. So reflecting part is inside. So reflection happens at the concave part, and the reflecting surface faces towards the center of sphere. So what type of mirror is this? Concave mirror. Right. Now here, this mirror will have one center. Every mirror will have one geometric center. By its geometry, by its structure, it will have one center. That center is called as pole. Right. So the second point, which is denoted by the letter P. Right. Now here, through this pole, and one line will be going. Right. So that line will be called as principal axis. So line which passes through the pole is called as principal axis, and it will pass through one another point at a. Now this I already told you, this mirror forms a part of sphere, right? So every sphere will have one center now. So that center is called as center of curvature. Center of the sphere in which the mirror forms a part is called as center of curvature. It is denoted by the letter C. Okay, so what are the points we have seen now? Center of curvature we have seen, pole we have seen, principal axis we have seen. Now usually in a circle, what is the distance between the center and any point on the circle circumference? How do we call it? We call it to be radius. Yes, no? So that radius here in this optical optics lesson, we call it with the name radius of curvature. Okay. So the distance between the center of curvature and the pole of the mirror. The pole of the mirror, we call it by one another word called vertex. I'll explain you what is that now. So the distance between center of curvature and the vertex of pole is called as radius of curvature. It is denoted by the letter R. Okay, and so I have told you what is called vertex. I am going to tell you now. So the point P is here, my children. How do we call it? Pole of the mirror, right? So this pole of the mirror is also called vertex, and it is at this point the principal axis. What is principal axis? It is the line passing through pole, I said, and that line will pass through another point, which is center of curvature. Now this principal axis will meet the mirror at one particular point, which is called as vertex. The point where the principal axis meets the mirror is called as vertex. Usually it will be the pole of the mirror. So it is a vertex is the other name for pole. Okay. So now principal axis I told you and focus. Focus is that we have two types of mirror, no children. One is concave mirror and another one is convex mirror. I told you, especially in the type of spherical mirrors. Right. Now here, in the case of concave mirrors, the light rays. This part is the reflecting part. I'll show you that mirror. Right. So now a concave mirror is there. If all the light is coming here and falling on it, so in this shape I am keeping it. Okay. Now what happens? All the light rays will come and fall on it, and what will happen? All the light rays will converge at one particular point. Converge means what? Meet at one particular point. Right. So that meeting point is called as principal focus. This is in the case of concave mirror. But if it is in the case of convex mirror, the light rays will look like it is diverging from that point. So in the case of convex, the light will diverge out. In the case of concave mirror, the light will converge, meet at one particular point. That's why these mirrors, concave mirrors are called as converging mirror and convex mirror is called as diverging mirror. Okay, so that part is just an additional point, so don't break your head for those points, right? So now here, in the case of concave mirror, what is that? All the light rays will converge at one particular point. In the case of convex mirror, it will diverge from that particular point. And that particular point is called as principal focus, denoted by the letter F, capital F. And now, and the distance between the principal focus and the pole of the mirror is called as focal length. It is denoted by the letter small f. It is denoted by the letter small f. It is the distance between the principal focus and the pole of the mirror and denoted by the letter small f. So what are the points we have seen? So as I show on the board, you are please tell along with me. This point is called as pole, center of the mirror. And this core point is called the center of curvature. Center of the sphere in this mirror forms the part, right? And this line is the principal axis. And the distance between center and the pole is called as radius of curvature. And the point where the light rays either converge or diverge is called as principal focus. And the distance between principal focus and the pole is called as focal length, denoted by the letter small f. Clear, children? So these terms in your notes I had given like continuous one. You either it can be asked in one for single 5 marks or individual 2 marks also it can be asked. Okay, for whatever question you have to be ready with the answer. Alright, so that is what I have written here. X dash is principal axis, C is the center of curvature, P is pole of the mirror, and F is the principal focus, CP is the radius of curvature, and EFP, this is not usual, kindly excuse, FP is the focal length. Okay, now this focal length and the radius of curvature, there is one relationship, children. See this diagram itself. This focus will be not this very closely, it will be at the center of this line. What is the line between the center of curvature and pole called as? It is called as radius of curvature. In that is capital F. Which what is capital F? Principal focus. It will be at the right, at the center. So that means this principal focus, we can say it can divide the radius of curvature into two parts. So that is what this formula I have written here. Focal length is equal to radius by 2. So radius of curvature is divided into two parts, then it is called as focal length. Otherwise we can write like radius of curvature is equal to. So this is your radius of curvature, no? So this is focal length, F means automatically this also will be F. So in one radius of curvature there will be 2 F. Right? So that is how you can interpret this. very very important concept children. And in your book there are two example sums you have. It has been given. So it's very simple sums. Focal length has been given in one sum. Radius of curvature has been asked. And in another sum, radius of curvature is given. Focal length has been asked. So simple division only. And even the numbers given in it is very very simple. So you can do it on your own. Based on the formula, F is equal to R by 2 and R is equal to 2 by 8. And that sums I have included in notes also. So please note it down. Right. So now all these concepts very very important children. Don't forget it. You will get this even in your 12th standard. So very important. Keep it in your mind. And we are moving to the image formation in a concave mirror. Now I will reach for concave mirror. You have to apply these in your convex mirror. Right. So now this diagram, if a mirror is there, right? So if a concave mirror is there, now if a mirror I have here, right? So now there are some objects have to be kept. So now example, the scale is to be kept as an object, right? So at different positions I can keep the object. So if I keep at different positions, how my image will be. So that is what we are going to see here. And children, usually children will get highly confused and highly, what is that, they feel this question to be very very tough. But this is very very easy. I will tell you how to learn it very easily without memorizing it. Okay. Now this is your mirror. So roughly you can draw your diagram in the rough column of your paper or your notebook. So one mirror you can draw. So right, one line you can draw. So you can mark P, you can mark C, you can mark F. So this is enough for your positions. Rough diagram you draw and keep. Right? So first object position, there are 6 object positions. So in the standard column contains 4 columns. One will tell you about objects or position, and one will tell you where you will get the image in the mirror and what type of size it will be and how the image will be. Right? Now you see that. Now at infinity means somewhere in the distance. So if an object is there at any distance, right? So where the image will be. And what is your next position beyond C? At C, between C and F, at F, between F and P. Little confusing, right? I'll tell you a simple method. Right. First one, I draw using your thumb. So here, this is a miniature part, I'll explain to you this bigger one. Right. So now somewhere at a greater distance, that word we will call it as infinity. Right? So where first fix the positions. First position is infinity. Okay. Now next one we will move this side. First we'll keep next to C. Right? Next to C we will call it with the word beyond C. Beyond, it is not behind. Beyond, keep that in your mind. Beyond C. Next one, what we will, where we can keep the object? It is at C. So first one, somewhere at infinity. Next we will keep the object beyond C. Then we will keep it at C. Then what is the position? C and F is there. So we can keep the position between C and F. Then at F and between F and P. So can we, without memorizing, just with this diagram, we can fix the positions. Can you see children once again? Now at any part you will see distance is taken as infinity. Next, beyond C. Next, at C. Between C and F. At F. Between F and P. Clear? So this is without memorizing. So fix the object position. Now we moved towards this side. When it comes to image formation, where image will be formed here, the image will move this side, right? So, related to this, I will show an activity at the end of this tabular column explanation. Okay. When we keep an object at infinity, if first thing, image will be obtained at one particular point, I told you, or the light rays will either converge or diverge from one particular point, I told you once again. So that particular point only we will get the image, right? When the object is at infinity. Okay, so first point you can easily keep in your mind. When the object is infinity, at infinity, image will get it at principal focus. So that is called focusing point. Okay, now object moves this side, image moves this side. First layer we got, image we got at principal focus. What is your next position between F and C? So that is what I have written over here. Next, at C. You can see here. Next position moved is beyond C. And next it goes somewhere else out of our vicinity. It is infinity. The last point, as it comes very very closer. Imagine what is the last position between F and P? No. So, as the image, the object becomes very very closer to the mirror, the image shifts from, what is that, one side to other side, right? So, it will be, what is that, if the image will be at behind the mirror. This point, the last point alone, you have to, what is that, give an extra concentration and keep it in your mind, behind the mirror, right? So, now, next one is, when in the image formation, image will be growing up in size. In that activity, what I am going to do, I will tell you that how it is growing up, right? First one, when for the first position, the image will be very very small. It is called as highly diminished, right? And when you move further, when the object is at beyond C, it will be not highly diminished. It will be smaller. Then when you keep the object at C, it will be same size as that of the object. Object and the image will be of same size. Then see here, highly diminished, same size. Now it will start to still grow. Right? First then it will come enlarged, then it is highly enlarged. Right? So very highly diminished, same size, enlarged, highly enlarged. And last one I told you, this last point alone you have to give a special attention and keep it in your mind. So generally it will be an enlarged image. Right. For all these positions I told you children, real and inverted. In the beginning itself I had explained you what are real images and what are virtual images. I will tell you that in that activity also now. Right. Real images are images which can be obtained on the screen. And virtual images are the images which cannot be obtained on the screen. Okay. Now this activity I will show you now. We will proceed with the activity now.
Children, in this activity, I will explain you about the real images and virtual images. Before I told you the screen, no children. Now we are going to see image formation in this screen, but with the help of a lens, not with the mirror first. I'll tell you why we are doing like that. First in the lens, no. So first I'll tell you what is lens. Lens means both the sides are reflecting. But in the case of mirror, you can see one side it is polished and another side it is reflecting. So this is lens. So using a lens, you will get a very clear image. But first we will see, you see that and experience it, and then I will get the image with the help of a mirror. And I'll tell you what are real images and virtual images also. Now this is convex lens. This you will learn in your higher classes. And this is concave lens. See here. When I am touching it, you see here, this is thinner at the center and thicker at the edges, right? Now here you see, this is convex lens and this is thicker at the center, thinner at the edges, right? Now first and this is magnifying lens, magnifying glass, right? This you would have seen in so many places. Where? Astrologers use now, right, to see the fingerprints. And even forensic science department people use it, and so many use we have in our daily life. So this is a type of a convex lens, right? So whatever convex lens properties we learn, that will go for concave mirrors also. So first see, I am going to focus some trees. So first see that, right? Can you see the image there, children? See? So now first thing you have to notice, we are getting the image on a screen. So what type of image is that? Real image, right? So now see, as I go closer, the image becomes bigger and becomes blurred, not clear. As I move further, and then it is becoming smaller. So depending upon the distance, the image will vary. Can you see that, children? How nice, no? But see, when you see the, when you focus, zoom your video and see, children, the image there will be inverted. I'll show you a pen now on the image. You can see how inverted it is. See, children, so as you are viewing through your video, it may not be clear. See, children, the hand movement is there. See, now actually the hand is shown in a different position. Now it is showing in an inverted way. Right now you can see in that screen. See, now one pen is shown there. Actually the pen is in the correct position, but there it is seen in an inverted way. Now you see the pen is in inverted position, right? So now the whatever position we keep over there, inverted way only we are able to see there in the screen, right, children? So this is convex lens. Okay, so can you see the image there? So if you have this lens at home, you can try it. Thank you, children. And now I will show it in the concave mirror. And children, now I am going to do it with a mirror. So this is a concave mirror, right? So which I had already done is convex lens, right? So I am keeping that apart now. Mirror will have one side only reflecting, no? So I had made the setup like this. So now I'll have the mirror. See here. I am getting the mirror window on the other side to be focused. So now, sorry, this side window, right? So now that image will come and focus on this. This is polished surface, so no reflection will happen. So this side only reflecting. So that reflecting part is getting focused to the trees and windows over here. So that rays will come here and get incident here, and it will get reflected over here. See now here. See how nice we are getting. So now we are getting a clear image, and even now you see here, children, we will get an inverted image. So this is about the image formation. You can see that it is, the size is getting increased or decreased. So here the image we got on the screen are called real images, and what we see inside it is an inverted image. So mostly real images will be inverted image. Virtual images we cannot get on a screen, so it will be always erect. Okay, children, thank you.